Welcome back to Straight Talk. I'm Laural Porter. We're talking with Oregon Congressman Earl Blumenauer. Let's talk about marijuana. You've been a leading voice on the issue of legalization of marijuana for years. You and I have talked about it here several times. You're a founding member of the Congressional Cannabis Caucus. You've said you think Democrats need to act now on your blueprint for federal legalization of marijuana. Do you think that's going to happen anytime soon?
Well, I think the odds are very strong that this will happen during this Congress. The people have spoken all across the country. 47 states now have some form of cannabis that's legal. There is growing public acceptance. Two-thirds of the public supports full legalization for medical cannabis. It's 90%, and most of these have occurred as a result of a vote of the people. We had a terrific victory before Congress adjourned with a vote in the Financial Services Committee, 3-1 margin, including some Republicans, to deal with the banking issue so that these state legal companies could have banking services. There's real momentum at the grassroots. We're seeing it around the country. And this fall, Mexico is going to fully legalize, joining our neighbors to the north in Canada, and we're sort of in between here.
Let's talk about safety. The Surgeon General came out with a stern warning this week that no amount of marijuana is safe for pregnant women and young people. We're also seeing a vaping epidemic among our youth, and many of them are vaping marijuana and adults as well. And this week we learned Oregon had the second vaping-related death in the country. Now I think as of Friday they're saying there are 5 across the country. And health officials say many of them are linked to vaping marijuana. And the one in Oregon, the person purchased the vaping device at a legal dispensary. So it raises a lot of questions about health and safety. Are you concerned that legalization could lead to more health problems?
You know, to the contrary, I think legalization, and one of the reasons I've led this charge in states across the country, is that legalization and regulation is the path for safety.
And how is that?
If most of America still gets their cannabis from a corner drug dealer, that person has no license to lose. You have no idea what's in it. They have every incentive to say, if you like this kid, here's something
else. But this one in Oregon, they're saying, came from a legal dispensary.
Yeah. And I'm saying that what we need is to be able to have a system where we can deal, for the federal government, as we talked about, prohibits research. But there will be 500,000 people who will die from cigarettes this year. One vaping death in Oregon. We don't still know exactly what happened and why, but I think having it legalized, regulated, studied, and then deal realistically with the dangers. One of the reasons I campaign so hard is I don't want kids to have marijuana. Right now, in every community that I've campaigned, they admit that it's easier for kids to get a joint than a six-pack of beer. We need to change that by being realistic, having strong regulations, good public education. I agree that we want to keep it out of the hands of children, pregnant women. Right now, how many women someplace are involved with self-medicating for extreme morning sickness by smoking marijuana? I'll bet you there are hundreds.
Are you concerned that, like big tobacco, if marijuana is legalized, there's a lot of investors and marijuana companies ready to pounce on that, and that marijuana will become big marijuana like big tobacco with their marketing tactics?
Well, I think that's specious. I mean, we already have big marijuana. The Mexican drug cartels, the black market, we have large operators that have made hundreds of millions of dollars, billions of dollars, out of something with a failed prohibition of marijuana. Done right, like we've done here in Oregon, having place carved out for small and medium-sized activities in a regulated market, I think is the way to go. The notion that somehow we haven't had big marijuana is just a fallacy. We have. It's just been illegal. It's been unregulated and untaxed.
I want to touch on this about gun violence. We saw more shootings this past weekend. A shooter killed 7 people in West Texas. Last month, we saw mass shootings in El Paso and Dayton. Dozens were killed and injured. Gun violence affects all of our communities. On your website, you outline 10 ways to reduce gun violence. One of them is background checks, which passed the House months ago. You're headed back to Congress. You reconvene both the Senate and House next week. Do you think that background checks, that bill, will finally pass in the Senate?
Well, I think there's a sea change that's going on. I mean, it was very jarring for me. I was in El Paso the day before the shooting, and it was just breathtaking to think of what had happened. But what we've seen since then, we're hearing that there's a little softening on the part of some Republicans, particularly those that are in tough elections. We've watched Walmart, the largest retailer in America, say, oh, we're not going to be selling ammunition for high-capacity assault weapons.
And other retailers followed suit this week.
We're watching the private sector. We're watching some politicians starting to say, be a little more circumspect about what they say. You're right. That was one of the first things we passed in this new Congress and sent universal background checks. But we have a whole range of things that the public supports, and in fact, a majority of members of the NRA support. I think we're starting to see a softening, and I suspect this is one of the areas where we may see some progress.
We only have about 25 seconds, but if you had to sum up how you're feeling about going back to Congress, going back to D.C., what would it be?
Well, it's always hard to leave after being able to spend a couple of weeks at home, but I am intrigued with the opportunities. I'm excited about sharing our housing activities and to try and see with the climate and gun safety if we can find a little bipartisan interaction.
I think everybody would like to see some bipartisanship. Congressman, thank you for joining us. Good luck back in D.C. Always a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you, Laurel.
And we want to let you know that Straight Talk is now available on podcast, so you can listen when it's convenient for you. Look for us wherever you typically get your podcasts. Just look for KGW Straight Talk. Thank you for watching and listening, and we'll see you next week for Straight Talk.